What's up, LHS? Welcome back to your Blue Devil News. I'm Emily.
And I'm Elena.
Anyone that would like to run for class office for the upcoming school year will need to attend the student council meeting on April 11th in B211. Also, the student council officer mixer is Monday from 2:30 to 3 o'clock in the library. Please make sure your coach or sponsor has emailed Ms. Robertson if you will be attending.
GSA meeting in Ms. Robertson's room on Tuesday from 2:30 to 3:30. We will have a special guest speaker.
FCA will have a meeting at 7 a.m. Thursday morning in the auditorium. Also, volleyball open gym starts today from 2:30 to 3:30.
HOSA will have the spring marketplace this Saturday from 8 to 12 here in the Commons.
Seniors, please go by guidance and fill out your information sheet.
FCA has shirts for sale at the bank for $10. The freshman class has long sleeve shirts for $22 and short sleeve for $15. There are also a few comfort shirts left for sale at the bank. They are $15.
The girls' basketball team is selling TSSAA state tournament shirts. Students can order at the bank or pay online, $15 for short sleeve and $20 for long sleeve. 2X and 3X have a slight up charge. We will take orders until Wednesday, April 17th. Now, let's throw it to Ian with sports.
What's up, LHS? I'm Ian, and this is your sports news. Over the weekend, the Preds defeated the Blackhawks. The final score was 5-2. The Blackhawks scored two goals in the first, shutting out the Preds. The Preds came back, scoring two goals in the second to tie the game. To top it all off, to clinch the game, the Preds scored three goals in the third. With this win, the Preds took first place in the division from the Jets. Here are some highlights.
It is game number 82, and Mace, it's a simple plan. Win, and the Predators have a second straight Central Division title. That's all you can ask for. Game 82, and you have to win a hockey game. You win the Central Division, but the Preds control their own destiny. They've got to come out, and they've got to beat the Blackhawks.
He is a water bug who can get it done from anywhere on the ice. Here's the break into the corner with Dylan Strome. Centers it out. Perlini scores! Pass stolen by Kane. Kane, what a pass! And Kajula beats Rene for a 2-0 lead. Looking for a pathway out, DeBrinket takes a swing at it, blocked by Hamhuis, juggled by Forsberg, leaves it, here's Favreau, he scores! Dante Favreau, first NHL goal!
He just lays it there for Favreau to pick up. Oh, look at all that daylight, and what a shot! Right over the glove of Cam Ward for his first NHL career goal.
The Predators have to make it happen. Granlund tried to float it towards Simmons. Man out of the box. Coming back into play strong. Forsberg booms one. He scores! Philip Forsberg pulls the slap shot out of the tool chest.
Three steps and just unloads a cannon through traffic off the bar and in. That setup is the most important thing, and it's the hardest thing to do, especially when you've been struggling on the power play at the Preds have.
Arvidsson cutting to the net, shooting, it scores! It's a new single season record! 34 goals for Arvidsson, and the power play goal puts the Predators in the lead for the first time tonight! Kane got it inside the line, picked up Taves right in front, what a save! Rene with the stick! Ellis was in the path as well.
This is incredible. This is all, look at this. Wide open net. Ryan Ellis, DeBrincat has a wide open net, and Ryan Ellis in perfect position. This puck is labeled. It's going in the back of the net.
Taves on the ice. It's a 6-on-5. The big weapon's out. Kane has the puck. Shoots. It's knocked down by Ellis. A chance to play it ahead. Sissons has Watson with him. Sissons. Yes, sir! Giving up. Tripped up. Set ahead. Bonino all by himself. He scores! Nick Bonino puts the icing on the cake, and the Predators are going to win back-to-back Central Division titles. Bridgestone Arena. Filled with gold jerseys, full of dreams. Predators are the Central Division champions for a second straight year.
What a way to finish
here at home with another comeback win. Congratulations, guys.
The first game of the playoffs for the Preds begins Wednesday at 8:30 against the Dallas Stars. Yesterday, the Braves defeated the Miami Marlins 4-3 to win the series. They take on the Rockies today beginning at 7:40. The Nashville Sounds take on Iowa tonight at 6:30. Tomorrow at 7, they will start their three-game series with Round Rock. March Madness is almost over. The championship game is today, Texas Tech versus Virginia. In the women's tournament, the Baylor Bears defeated the Irish 82-81 to win the championship. Check it out.
Breaks the scoring seal on the championship game. Landrum's got the range. And she's got the three. Numbers for Baylor. Landrum to Jackson. Jackson sees the clock. Tries to beat the buzzer. And does. Tara Lawson and Rebecca Lobo are rolling. So is Chloe Jackson. Hard the Irish have had to work just for a look. But it's a good one for Ogunbowale. A minute to go here in the half. What a pass by Landrum to Brown. Jackson all the way, left it short. Brown did not. In the game, Arike Ogunbowale was with our Holly Rowe moments ago as Cox scores. In this championship game against Baylor 7 years ago. Jackson, wow, what a clutch bucket that was. Landrum trying to get free. Knocks down the three. Since Baylor took an 11-point lead into the second quarter. Chloe Jackson has been on it tonight. Jackson finds herself free and knocks it down. Looking for Mabry again. Has been erased. Melissa Smith puts Baylor back in front. How you feeling, Holly Rowe? Brown into the paint. Felt like it's been a while since we've seen that. Jackson in her final game. Puts Baylor in front with 33 seconds to go. It's Jackson on the drive for the lead. Got it to go. 3.9 left. It's good with 1.9 left. Denied by Turner, and that's it. The Baylor Lady Bears, 7 years later, are back at the top of college basketball with their third national championship.
UT's baseball team takes on Lipscomb tomorrow at 5. Vandy's baseball team takes on MTSU tomorrow at 6:30. I'm Ian, and this has been your sports news. Back to you, ladies.
Thanks, Ian.
The math lab room is open from 2:30 to 3:15 in A104. If you need help for any math class, stop by. Students can bring homework, quizzes, practice problems, notes, or anything else they need help with.
Students can now sign up for the Lip Sync Battle hosted by the Blue Devil Players on April 26th. There's a sign-up sheet on the auditorium doors, and groups can be no more than 5 people.
The Humane Society will meet Tuesday afternoon in C200 at 2:30. If you bought a shirt, please wear it for a picture. Officer Brian will be our guest speaker and will bring his canine to the meeting, so have your questions ready.
The Spring Dance Showcase is Tuesday, April 16th at 6:30 p.m. Admission is $5.
FFA plant sale begins this Wednesday, April 9th through the 19th. Regular hours are Monday through Friday from 8 to 4. Special hours are Saturday, April 13th from 8 to 12, and Good Friday will be from 8 to 11. We have hanging baskets ranging from $10 to $15 and many more options to choose from. Signs will also be posted in the median on South Hartman. All of the plants in the greenhouse are grown and cared for by the students in the greenhouse management class.
Wednesday, April 10th at 7 p.m., the Blue Devil Rugby Football Club will face off against Siegel High School at home. This is the last home game of the season, and it's free admission. Please come by and support your Blue Devils.
The Choir Pop Concert will be Thursday, April 18th, starting at 6:30 p.m. Admission is $5, and this is a fundraiser concert. For the next few weeks, LHS Football is selling World's Finest Candy Bars. The cost is $1. Find any football player to buy one.
Cheer trials will be April 10th through the 12th in the small gym from 2:45 to 4:30. Packets can be picked up in B203. Well, that's all the news we have for today, LHS. I'm Emily.
And I'm Elena.
And this has been news to you from the white and blue.
Con. Hello. Wait.
The way she just said hours, I've never heard anyone speak like before in my entire life.
Was it hours?
She was like, hours.
Well, I didn't see. I don't know what I said. It was not even English. And I couldn't stop laughing.
Why don't you take this basketball back down the snake?
Well, we said to catch it.
Oh, yeah, we gotta have to catch it, don't we?
Come on, Ian.
Okay, let me just drop my spot. I keep it very simple.